Canucks, now they got 8 wins. You know, this was a rebuilding year for them, right? We expected them to be right there at the bottom of the division with the Vegas Golden Knights, but they played pretty well. I know they've lost a couple in a row. How dangerous a team can they be tonight?
Confidence is the big thing in Kempe's game right now. He's been riding with it, and it has been good for the Kings.
And the consistency has been there. Now, it's a long season, but for a young player, that's usually what wavers, goes up and down. But I think what you're saying, Alex, he knows he can do it now.
Turnover. Pearson shot. Score! Opening minute, and the Kings have the lead.
Now, is there a turnover? Yes, there is. It's right there. Not connected. And then all of a sudden, outside the dots, does it hit the side of the body? We'll take a look here again to see. Anything outside the dots is usually considered a bad. It goes into the midsection and just sneaks over top of that pad. So you can see that with Nilsson. He's not really comfortable in that situation. Bottom line, it's a bad goal from a bad angle, but it was preceded by a clear-cut turnover right up the middle of the ice. The Kings pounce on it. Kings need 1-0.
Fed to the corner by Anders Nilsson. Kings keep it in the zone, however. Played across. Kopitar moving in. Big rebound from Nilsson. It wasn't too far away from Dustin Brown, who was ready to pull the trigger.
The Kings' movement of the puck is so efficient here. There's a rebound. It just, if you're Dustin Brown, you cannot predict where that rebound's going. And you saw how fast that was. It went directly, and it did clip his stick right there.
Iafallo wins it back. Martinez, a little head fake, shuffles the puck to Kopitar. On his backhand, finds Doughty. A drive through traffic, whistles wide. Martinez sends it down low. Iafallo around the boards. Brown behind the goal with time expiring. They score! Andrzej Kopitar, front of the net, and his ninth straight game with a point results in a 2-0 lead.
But it's just that down low play. Right, watch Brown get it off the boards. His ability to get it off cleanly, and such a subtle pass by Dustin Brown. He doesn't throw it hard. And you know what? I'm looking at Nilsson again. If a pass like that goes through the crease, you've got to try to get a stick on it. He's not able to get a stick on it. And Andrzej Kopitar says, I'll get a stick on it. It's one of Pearson's on his off wing there, coming out of the right side, and it was on his backhand. Could not get the puck. Looked like a little handcuff.
Dustin Brown, onside pass for Kopitar. Back for Brown. A shot off the skate of Alex Edler. Back into the circle. Drew Doughty off the bench. A shot is saved by Nilsson.
Here's the play just off to the side. Sticks in good position. Now, again, credit the Vancouver Canucks there. The coverage ends up just not allowing Tanner to make an extra stick handle and get the puck back in front of the goal line on the other team, so they can't continue that cycle.
The power play's been a sore spot in Vancouver for years. Continues to be one. One-timer save. Rebound put through the crease and wide. Sedin was set up feet away from the goal, but put it through the blue paint and through to the other side. Kopitar for the half board, stick handling, looking for one last shot. Doughty had to settle with his skate. Spins around. Drew Doughty centering pass. Kopitar in his offhand. Fires it through the middle. Puck loose in the slot. Jammed towards the goal and cleared out by Vancouver. Restarted by Derek Pouliot. And here's Erickson onside. A shot off the blocker of Quick. Erickson regathers behind. Sent through the middle and in. Pinballing off of Daniel Sedin in front. And the Vancouver Canucks get on the board after an acute angle pass found its way through.
So here comes the shot. It's going to go off the backside of Nick Shore. So you can see Jonathan Quick is trying to find it, but it already hit his teammate. It's something you can't predict. And the coverage is okay, so to speak. But it's just a matter of time. I asked John after the last game, because it was mentioned by a couple players after that, whether the Kings sat back. I didn't think they did.
Horvat sweeps it along.
Yeah, Horvat's doing a good job in front right here, creating screen difficult for the goaltender to find it.
That got all the way to Besser. Puck hopped in the air and swatted in by Horvat. A power play goal for the Vancouver Canucks, and the game is tied at 2.
You could call it a fortunate bounce because it goes high into the air and lands in behind, but because of the body of work that Horvat had on that shift, he knew exactly what his role was on this power play, and that was to go to the front. Vancouver's been talking lately. That seemed to me a little bit of a hybrid between their first and second units, with the Sedins out there along with Horvat. Well, you get the bounce, you get the body position, and you don't leave the front of the net.
Oh. Horvat sweeps it around, turned over in front. A look from Kempe, off to Foley, and that bounced off of a body in front. Kempe in the corner.
There's the initial turnover, stick position by Toffoli. I believe here that Nielsen gets a piece of it. We'll see the protection of the puck by Toffoli, and maybe the shoulder of the tender, just as big as possible. Great look, guys, from down at ice level. Just perfect right there. Sometimes wow. Position, you see, he didn't move. He really couldn't see it.
Sure, cross-ice pass intercepted by Dorsett. Canucks on the break the other way. Brendan Gaunt speeds ahead, and a poke check from Jonathan Quick prevented that from being a clear scoring opportunity for Sutter. It's a penalty against the Kings.
So does the foul come from behind? Neat little pass, Gaunt. And it's into the hands.
No problem with that. Third time the Kings have faced a penalty shot. And Quick stops it. Now Brandon Sutter didn't have much deception on his entry, and Quick ran it the whole way.
And I'm not sure if he was kind of faking the poke check or not. Right there, you see it now? And he forced the shot, if anything.
Muzzin stops it with a glove hand, keeps it alive. Toffoli does the same. Doughty across for Muzzin on a D-to-D pass. Muzzin through the middle, a redirection glove down by Nielsen. That's a tough save.
And it's a good job there by Kempe. Being accessible, look at, he's got his stick on the ice. He's almost telling Jake, hey, Jake, I'm here, I've got it. Now, if there's any loose puck, Tanner Pearson's right there, too.
As Vancouver looks for one last go of it on this power play. Over the line, Thomas Vanek plays it across, they score! Sven Bertschy streaking into the circle, buries it top corner. Vancouver with three unanswered goals to take the lead.
So you take your time on the breakout. Credit Vancouver for that. A little bit of a bunt back to speed. And from this point on, the Kings get three men over on one side, and that's okay under certain circumstances. There's the pass. It was important right there for the Vancouver Canucks to keep driving to the net.
Doughty's outlet pass tipped off a defensive stick. Here's Iafallo, put in front for Martinez. Maybe off of Nielsen, maybe off of the post. Either way, the Kings with a golden chance that goes awry.
Martinez, backdoor, much like the Canucks scored their goal. He gets a piece of it. Does the tender get a piece? Certainly a crossbar gets a piece. Opportunity here for the kick. More offensive zone faceoff.
Tyler Toffoli won it back. This line's back together with Kempe and Pearson. Pearson, Toffoli, Kempe! Saved by Nielsen. Tic-tac-toe set up and Nielsen sliding across.
The Kings were able to do that. Canucks couldn't get out. Watch this. Low, high, bang. You can't execute any better than that, but then you turn your attention to the goaltender. Watch Nielsen. One step across, square up, and use the big body.
Fed up the boards by Vancouver, but not out. Second try by Sutter. Gets it back to center with 8 seconds left. Time ticking away. Kopitar attempted to spin it in. Cut off by the Canucks. They shoot to the empty net. It's wide, but it doesn't matter. Vancouver rallies back from down 2-0. And a come-from-behind effort against the LA Kings, who look like they were on their heels a good portion of this game, especially in the second period, and couldn't muster enough in the third to come back and get the tying goal. Frustration